Two Bigfoot sightings from the great state of Texas. Charles writes RMSO. Seen one in Texas when I was a kid. We respond, what happened? Did you get a good look, size, color, facial features? What time of day? What time of year? Charles writes back, yes, it was wading in the creek about 9 feet deep. I was 100 yards away, fishing on the creek in the evening. I had three bad dogs with me. It was brown, thick hairs. Its head was like that of an old caveman. I respond, amazing, you are very lucky because Bigfoot sightings are very rare. Charles responds, the smell was very bad. Lasted 2 days. Got this on my game cam. The camera was 4 feet off the ground. What do you think? I respond, definitely lots of dark brown hair. Was this in the area that you had your sighting? Charles responds, about a half a mile. I respond back, excited to see that you're trying to get footage of the creature. Keep us posted. The next Texas Bigfoot sighting, Rob B. writes RMSO. Hi, I was in West Texas and I was hunting. The closest city to me was Comstock. I was sitting in a Bronco enjoying the view, but from across the canyon, I saw a blackish-brown creature dragging a deer carcass to a cave. I grabbed a pair of binoculars and zoomed in on the creature. I saw that it was very dark skin and had a very flat nose. Its eyes were very bright amber color. It had a very thick hair around the torso and legs, but lightened up around the face. It had a very large ape-like lips. The terrain was very rocky, so it was very good at climbing and maneuvering the terrain. RMSO responds, hi Rob, how long were you able to observe the creature? Did you see it drag the deer into the cave? Rob responds, hi, I would say that I observed the creature for about 5 minutes. I was about 200 yards away. I did see the creature go into the cave. The cave was up on at least 5 foot ledge, but he just stepped up there like he was climbing stairs. The deer was about the size of a smaller elk. This was the biggest buck I ever saw. It was at least 5 feet in length and was pretty wide. I would have to say that the creature was at least 7 feet tall. The shoulder length would be about 4-5-ish. They were very wide. The creature's face was very ape-like. It did not resemble a person in the face. It was very scarred looking and looked similar to that of the gorilla in the eyes, but the jaws did not extend from the face like a gorilla or a chimp did. It looked similar to a human in the jaws. The teeth were that of an ape, though. The skin was dark brown. RMSO responds, thank you for the additional details. What time of day, the month, and how many years ago do you recall? Rob responds, the time of day was early morning, I think, but I remember it was rainy. The month was December, and it was about 2 years ago. Hi, Rob. If you ever get a chance, please go up into that cave, take a look around, see what you can find. Keep us updated. Appreciate you sending us your Bigfoot sighting report. Anyone else has a Bigfoot sighting report, whether it happened last year, 10 years ago, 100 years ago, we want to hear from you. Please email us at rmsobigfoot@gmail.com. We just love these reports. We like to investigate areas, especially if they have multiple reports. Gives us a history of Bigfoot in areas. It helps point us in the right direction when there's a history of multiple sightings over the years. Keep on watching. We're going to keep on squatching.